Magandang palang araw po muli sa ating lahat at mga sa kataga-SBC, purihin po ang Panginoong Diyos sa inyong pagsama sa amin. At gayon din po, ngayon nabalitaan ko, hindi lang po mga taga-CMG, hindi lang po mga taga-Emerald Garments, pati po sa mga taga-Toyota, Dagupan, nakakasama rin po natin. Nakakasama rin natin ilan natin mga kaibigan sa Mitsubishi. At alam po ninyo, nakakatuwa po ang Panginoon Diyos that we are given this a privilege na makapag-usap-usap tayo habang nagmimerienda. So ang tawag natin dito ay snack break time cheers. So nawa po ang ating mga usapin ay makatulong po sa ating pagharap sa mga pagsubok na kasalukuyan nating nahahamon, parang naging hamon sa atin o nakikihamok ko tayo in a sense, no? The challenges that we're facing nowadays. Now, with this new normal, hindi ho naging madali ho ang adjustment. And I'm telling you, up to today, some people are still adjusting. At hindi ho siya talaga, hindi ho talaga siya ganun kadali. And we're still expecting and hoping that things will get to the original normal. But the truth is this, sa bagay na ito, we need to begin to think anew. Yan po ang ating pinag-uusapan sa bagong serya natin. We need to think anew. Kailangan natin matutunan yung sinabi ni Paul, forgetting what lies behind but looking forward to what lies ahead. It is a challenge of really reinventing ourselves, and it always starts with our mind. Sabi natin, last time that we met, last Thursday, kung nakasama niyo po kami, sabi natin that we need to understand how to control our thoughts that controls us. Kasi tatanda natin, what we think normally affects the way we feel. And what we feel affects the way we behave. And may nagsabi, if you think, sabi niya, sow a thought, you sow an action. Diba? If you sow an action, you reap a habit. If you sow a habit, you will reap a destination. So napaka-importante that you need to understand na kailangan makontrol mo yung isip mo na yon. So how should you do that? Naalala nyo, last time we talked about surrendering our thoughts to God. Kasi ho, kung hindi natin ito isusurrender sa Diyos, hindi ho lalawak yung ating pong pananaw. We need to see things from God's perspective para lumawak po yung ating pananaw. And kaya nga sabi ng Bible, therefore I beseech you, sabi niya, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as living sacrifice. Then Paul said, sabi niya, do not conform into the standard of this world, but be it transformed with the renewing of your mind. Now that you belong to God, now that you have understood and admitted your need of God, I want you not to conform any longer with the ways of the world, but to start renewing your mind. So there's a challenge of surrendering your thoughts to God. And nakita rin natin last week na ating pag-uusap that we need to start thinking out of the box. Hindi na tayo kailangan magpakulong sa ating mga normal na kinagagawian noon. Today, I want to emphasize on one thing. We need to shape our mind on what is essential. And normally, the things that are really essential is something that will last for eternity. We need to set direction for our mind. It is our responsibility. You know, it is our responsibility to feed our mind properly. Kaya if you want to think anew, tatandaan nyo, if we are the one controlling our thoughts, tayo rin ang magpapakain ito. If we think bad thoughts, obviously our lives would be bad. Kaya if we think good thoughts, obviously it will bring good life. Kaya po importante how we handle our mind. Sabi ng Bible, this is how we should manage our brain, how to think anew. First, acquire wisdom, acquire understanding. Sabi nga ho ni Solomon sa Proverbs 4:5, acquire wisdom, acquire understanding, do not forget nor turn away from the words of my mouth. What he was saying is, don't turn away from the teachings of those who have gone ahead of us. Don't turn away from the teachings of our parents. Marunong, yung parents ko hindi naman marunong turo. But at least you know na hindi siya pala marunong. Di kunin mo lang yung natutunan mong tama from him or from your parents. Yung mali, di, hiwalay mo. Bakit? Kasi the beginning of wisdom is to acquire wisdom. We need first to learn to listen. Minsan, we reject the thoughts or the wisdom that comes from the elderly kasi feeling natin we are more wise than them. But the truth is, their experience will also tell us na hindi, meron silang pinagdaanan, that the reason why they're giving us warnings. They may not like imitating them because of their past mistakes, but they also want somehow to tell us what's wrong, and so that we would avoid what they had perhaps chosen na maling daan. So, yun ang sinasabi ng Bible. Kaya we need to keep, the first thing that we need to learn is to admit that we need to learn. We need to be humble enough to admit that we do not know everything. Kaya sabi niya, the beginning of wisdom is acquire wisdom. And with all acquiring, as you are learning, as you are listening, as you are hearing or reading, ganyan sa mga panahon na to, if you feel that you are somehow naka-quarantine ka pa, o kaya nandiyan ka sa trabaho but you are not working as ano, parang ano, yung parang as before na parang yung schedule mo punong-puno, then start using that opportunity to acquire wisdom. Then as you acquire, as you read, as you listen, get understanding. Hindi lang pinararami mo yung knowledge mo. Try to understand how it is being ano parang done in real life situation, how it is being practiced. Kumbaga, huwag mo lang matutunang maglaga ng itlog. Gawin mo at gamitin mo yung paglaga ng itlog na maging negosyo sa buhay mo o maging ano, maging tulong sa iyong kabuhayan. Ibig sabihin, huwag kang tumigil doon. Try to understand. Di ba? Try to understand. Kumbaga, huwag mo lang alamin ano yung boiling point. Kunya, natutunan mo sa science. Gamitin mo sa totoong buhay. So what does it do? What does, how does it ano, parang operate in my real life situation? Itong amazing. If you really want to get understanding and have a better perspective in life, ano sabi ng Bible? Sabi niya, the fear of God is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is understanding. That is something old, but we need to think anew and say, hindi ko to naiisip pa. Parang akala kong wisdom, just get on that. Parang pag lumapit ka sa Diyos, parang hindi yan magaling. Hindi. The truth is this. You will understand better if you fear God. And not only that, yung knowledge of the Holy One will give you a better understanding and better insight on things that you're getting to know. Kaya ho, napaka-importante nun. Kaya ito ho ang dapat nating maintindihan. If we feed ourselves with wisdom, ano sabi niya? You need to seek for it as if you're seeking for jewels. As if you are desiring to get gold. As if you're wanting somehow to get some precious stones. Ganun ba tayo maghanap ng wisdom? Ganun ba tayo umunawa sa buhay? Kaya ho, ito ho yung challenge ho sa atin. If you think bad thoughts, let me repeat, if you think bad thoughts, uulitin ko, your life will be bad. If you think dumb thoughts, for sure, your life would be dumb. And if you think smart thoughts, your life will have us. You will have a smart life. And think good thoughts, obviously, you will give you good life. This is why I want us all to understand, we need to shape our mind to make it good. Paano? Ano bang mga magagandang kaisipan? The Bible teaches us somehow, sa ano, si Paul, for example, he tells us to think on what is eternal, to think on what is above. Kaya set your mind on one things above. Yun nga po, kasi nga po, the idea is this, ano ba yung worth for eternity na kaisipan? Ano ba yung mga bagay? If you're thinking something that will not be worthy or parang ayaw mo to be with you in eternity, iwasan mo na yun. Hindi mabuti yun. So anything that feeds your mind to make it bad, iwasan mo yun. Kaya nga, you are the one responsible to shape your mind. Yes, God will help us. Yes, God can change us. But God expects us to do our part. In other words, to be responsible in shaping our mind. Alam niyo po ba na kapag na-shape natin yung mind natin, it will spare us from so many troubles. It will even give us a better understanding of how we handle our issues in life. Yung mga bagay na ano na, kunyari, kinabukasan. For example, maaaring mga tao, they keep on feeding themselves with fear. They pass text from one, pass text to, with what they receive and pass it to another. Puro mga bagay na nakakatakot. They could not even confirm it. Mga conspiracy theory, kung ano-ano, mga ano. Now, I'm not saying na mali yun o hindi ko sinasabi na mga hindi totoo yun. What I'm saying is, what are you feeding? Why are you feeding yourself with fear? Why are you feeding yourself with issues or problems one after another? Why don't you fill yourself with solution? Why don't you fill your mind with what you can do in order to overcome your fear? Kaya nga, you need to shape your thinking with what will help you to make your life better. At ang ganda niyan, tinuturuan tayo ng Diyos. Ang Diyos mismo magbibigay sa atin ng wisdom. Kaya huwag nating hayaan na kontrolin tayo ng ating sirkumstansya. No, huwag nating hayaan na ang magsi-shape sa atin yung mga bagay sa paligid natin. Yung iba, they shape their mind with lustful thoughts. Yung iba, they shape their mind with yung mga with evil thoughts. Huwag, kasi sinisira mo lang sarili mo. Ngayon kung may mga basura ka, tapo mo na 'yan. Kaya nga ingatan mo, kaya sabi natin sa computer, garbage in, garbage out. So avoid putting in garbage in our brain. Avoid, as in, para walang garbage out. Ang mahalaga, feed it with what is, parang kumbaga sa pagkain, nutritious. Diba? Helpful. Kasi it's spare ka sa trouble. For example, tinanggal ka sa trabaho. Some people, wala na trabaho, wala na. Nag-aalala ka na. You feed your thoughts with sana ako kakuha ng pagkain. Sana ako. Bakit yun ang iisipin mo? Isipin mo muna ganito. You begin to think that you are the job. Your job is not in the company. You are the job. Sino ka ba talaga? Do you really know who you are? What do you really think of yourself? Do you really think of yourself as you got nothing? Hindi. You are created by God in His image. And our God, who is so creative, He has also given us creativity. So huwag kang magpumayag na ganito lang ba to? No. Now, since God has given us a mind to communicate with Him, why not come and ask God, Lord, grant me wisdom. Tell me what to do. Teach me on what to do. Then little by little, as He would inspire you, simulan mo, gawin mo, huwag kang matakot. Kasi magplano ka, dahil alam mo, kasama mo ang Diyos. So you feed and shape your mind with what is necessary. Huwag kang magdwell sa fear, magdwell ka saan? Sa wisdom that comes from the Lord. Para sa halip na manatili kang takot, nagkakaroon ka ng panibagong pag-iisip. Anong pag-iisip? Shape your mind with the things that is essential, things that are essential, things that are eternal. Yan ang napakamagandang bagay. So you better shape your thinking. Now, may I suggest, itong mga possibility, what are you reading? You ask yourself, ano ba mga pinagbabasa ko? Diba? To me, I read biographies that would inspire me on how they handled their difficulties in the past. It helped me a lot. I read, for example, hindi lang yung mga biographies, but I read the things, the principles of God, as in what makes them alive. Alam niyo na what makes them parang pursue the things of the Lord. Yung mga ganyan ba? Kaya every day of my life, I read my Bible. Kasi doon pa lang ang ganda ng encouragement, di ba? I read inspirational books. I read, for example, devotional books. I read so many things that would make my brain operate for what is necessary for me, not only to survive, but to thrive and to accomplish the work that God wants me to fulfill. So what are you feeding your mind? What are you watching? Pati yan. What are you watching? Think anew. If you want to start thinking anew, then watch something new. Mamili ka ng papanoorin mo. Mamili ka yung mga hindi, yung mga, tayo mahilig, drama dito, drama, iyak, puro frustration after frustration, busted dito, busted dyan, pag-iganti dito, pag-iganti dyan. Ano finifeed natin sa sarili natin? Diba? Parang we need to think on, watch something na, ganito pala, marami, ang daming pelikula. Katulad ng isa, Facing the Giants, ang ganda-ganda. Parang courageous, parang may something courageous. Parang, wow, ang daming mga magaganda. Ako, hindi ako mahilig man sa mga ganyan. Pero somehow na, yung sa panonood ko ganyan, pinipili ko lang. Kasi iniisip ko lang kung ano yung makakatulong sa akin. So, piliin nyo. Musika na pinakikinggan. you choose the music that you're listening to. Why? Because it feeds your mind. So what I'm saying is this, you shape your mind on what is essential. You shape your mind for what is eternal. Now, let me end with the story. Naalala ko po may isang story po about Mandela. This is amazing about life. Ano po? Sa mga pagkakataon, if you are thinking anew, you know how to think out of the box, you know how to feed and shape your mind properly, ililigtas ka pa rin ng Panginoon Diyos through your mind sa mga insulto. For example, if you understand justice, if you understand righteousness, if you understand to value other people, magugulat ka, alam mo rin paano ka sumagot sa buhay. One time, si Nelson po, since he was studying in University of Witwatersrand, nagkataon po, mayroon siyang white professor. And during that time, ang lakas po nung tinatang na apartheid, yung they put down the colored people, especially the blacks. When one day, yung kanyang teacher, si Mr. Peters, was having lunch at the dining room when Mandela came along with this tray and sat next to the professor. Kasi nga, para sa kanya, you need to give the same respect, whatever color they have, balang mo, mahalin mo, value them. Yan. Ang problema po, this professor was a little bit medyo iba. Parang medyo discriminating to the blacks. Sabi mo naman niya, Mr. Mandela, you do not understand. Hindi mo ito naintindihan. Yung baboy at yung ibon, hindi yan umuupo ng sabay para kumain ng pananghalian. Grabe! What an insult! Parang sinasabi niya, hindi tayo dapat magkasama. Bilang mong gamitin niyang baboy at ibon? Ano sabi ni Mr. Mandela, because he, with such great respect, and using that very sarcastic na comment, ano sabi niya? Di bali po. Ay, sa English, ito ang pagkasabi niya. So Mandela looked at him as a parent, would a rude child, and calmly replied, with all due respect, sabi niya, you do not worry, professor. I'll fly away. And he went and sat at another table. Ang sinasabi niya, ako bilang ibon, lilipad ako palayo. At ikaw namang baboy, ikaw magstay dyan. Diba? Parang nagligtas sa kanya sa kahihiyan na parang, see, in front of others, ganun ang sasabihin ng professor. Siyempre, nagalit yung professor, namula siya, and sabi niya, gaganti ako sa iyo. Again, that's foolishness. To revenge, that's foolishness. That's not essential. That's not thinking eternal. Dati niya, eto, sa paghiganti niya, akala niya nakabut sa kanya. Tinawag niya ulit si Mr. Mandela sa klase. Mr. Mandela, if you are walking down the street and found a package, and in it was a bag of wisdom and another bag with money, which one would you take? Diba? Ano pipiliin mo? Bag ng wisdom or bag ng pera? Si Mr. Mandela, siyempre, sumagot agad. Sabi niya, siyempre sir, yung bag of money, yun ang kukunin ko. Si Mr. Mandela, siyempre, ngumiti, sarcastic ulit, at sabi niya, you know what? If I'm in your place, I would have taken the wisdom. Parang iniinsulto na naman si Mandela. Now, look at this. Nelson Mandela shrugged and responded, you see, each one takes what he doesn't have. Diba? Parang balik na naman dun kay Mr. Peters. Kasi sa kanyang pag-iisip, paghihiganti, pang-iinsulto, di balik sa kanya yung pang-iinsulto ginawa niya. Bakit? Ang basurang tinapon mo, basura din ang babalik sa'yo. And finally, Mr. Peters by this time was about to throw a fit. Like, sobrang galit na siya. Talagang sisiguraduhin niya makakaisa na siya kay Mandela. Sa atin, seething with fury, so great was his anger that he wrote on Nelson Mandela's exam paper or exam sheet word, idiot. Bino mo yung papel, chinikan, lagay, idiot. And gave it to the future struggle icon. Now, ito ang amazing. Mandela took the exam sheet and sat down at his desk, trying very hard to remain calm. Kalmado lang. Bakit? Wisdom. Wisdom on what is essential. While he contemplated his next move, a few minutes later, si Nelson Mandela got up, walked up to the professor and told him in a dignified and polite tone. Ginoon mo, andun pa rin yung galang, andun pa rin yung pantamang tono, walang galit, pagmamayabang. Sabi niya, Mr. Peters, you see, you signed your name on the sheet, but you forgot to give me my grade. Then, parang siyempre, kalmado, pero he bring back the insult that Mr. Peter was trying to give or to throw at Mandela. Now listen to this. don't mess with intelligent people. But most of all, never ever discriminate, look down, or hate other people simply because you don't like their skin color or their behavioral norms. What I'm saying is this. This is how you shape your mind. See, God, He loves justice. He loves loving kindness. He delights on those things. He loves or He delights in righteousness. And imagine, if you shape your mind with the mind of God, you will also do the same. When you think of a business, think of a business that is loving kindness. Think of a business that is righteous, just. When you do your work, instead of thinking of worries, trying to again shortcut to cut corners, no, think of what is right. Think of what is just. Think of what is loving. And you will see how this wisdom works. Kaya, learn to think anew. Ano nga po yung mga principles so far na tutunan natin? You surrender your thoughts to God first. Then you begin to start thinking out of the box. As in, hindi lang tayo to normal. See the unseen things. And finally, shape your mind with what is essential. Technically speaking, what is eternal. Anong pinag-iisipan mo ngayon? Think anew. God bless you.